Hey guys, welcome to our channel. I am Zhenya from Attitude Creative, and you may already know that I love creating vector gradient designs in Adobe Illustrator. Recently, I decided to shake things up a little and experiment with creating raster gradient artworks instead. And in this tutorial, I will be sharing with you my process and tips and tricks for creating experimental organic abstract gradient artworks in Adobe Photoshop. Photoshop allows you to work with gradients in a different way in comparison to Illustrator, and what I will share in this video is a fun, quick, and easy technique to explore. The artworks you can create using this technique are stunning in their own right, but they can also be used as graphic elements in your designs or as backgrounds for presentations, social media posts, or digital wallpapers. And when you get started with this technique, it is really hard to stop, as it is very addictive in a good way. So let's jump right in. Let's start with the document setup. I recommend using a canvas size of at least 4000 by 4000 pixels to have some room for cropping and to be able to use your work on screen in 4K. Personally, I prefer to create my artwork in a size suitable for large prints. So I will be using a canvas size of 6000 by 6000 pixels instead, with a resolution set to 300 ppi. Make sure to select RGB color mode and a white background here. So let's create this document and then save it right away in a PSD format. To create the base shapes in the artwork, select the brush tool and choose the standard soft round brush with hardness set to 0. In the options bar, set the brush mode to difference and make sure that the rest of the settings look like this and set to 100%. Next, set the foreground color to white. This is crucial, otherwise nothing will work. Now let's increase the brush size to something pretty large in relation to the canvas size and start drawing on the background layer filled with white. As we are drawing with the brush in a difference mode, each new stroke you start after releasing the mouse button will create an inverted look over the area you are drawing on. And with the soft brush, it creates this sort of gradients and transitions between the shapes. It may not be super straightforward or predictable when you're just getting started with this technique, so my advice is just to play around drawing shapes over each other and make a mess if you need to get a better understanding of how it works. And once you've got the hang of it, you can simply fill your layer with white yet again and start working more intentionally and slowly. There are many shapes and effects you can create with this technique, but I often find that less is more, and I like working with large strokes and space them out to create interesting organic shapes. Okay, this is looking pretty good to me. Sometimes what you draw is great as it is, but if you want to further develop the shapes in your artwork, you can create a copy of your layer, convert it into a smart object if you want to distort it non-destructively, and then go and play around with the Liquify filter. Here you can use any of the tools available to distort the shapes. I personally like using the forward warp tool with these settings to make gradual and not too drastic changes, and then switch to a smaller brush to work on the smaller details if necessary. With the Liquify filter, you can create endless variations based on the same original image. So have fun experimenting and create any effect you like. And this looks pretty good to me. So I am going to apply changes. After creating and distorting your shapes, you might find that your artwork needs a little more contrast. Personally, I often end up with pretty dark images with barely any highlights. But here is a little trick you can use to non-destructively lighten or darken certain areas of your artwork. First, hit Command-Shift-N or Control-Shift-N in Windows to create a new layer. In this dialog, set the mode to Overlay and check this box here, which will allow you to quickly create a new layer filled with a neutral gray color and set to Overlay. Now, with the new layer created, let's copy it a few times, as we will most likely need multiple copies to achieve the desired effect. Next, let's select the bottom of these neutral gray layers, and I will be using it to bring out some highlights in the shapes. For this, I will use the Dodge tool, set it to Midtones, and keep these settings like this. And then go and start brushing on the areas I want to bring out, like so. And if you need to make certain areas darker, you can use the Burn tool instead. It is great to use a separate layer for dodging and burning, but sometimes you can hit the limit of how much you can do in a specific area if you make it white or black. And in this case, you can use another neutral gray layer and work on the same areas to make them even lighter or darker. By using this technique, you can easily add as much contrast and depth to your artwork as you want, and all that without damaging the original image. Alright, now let's work on the tones a bit more. So let's add a new curves adjustment layer and have some fun with it to give this artwork an extra kick. The great thing about curves is that you can do whatever you want with them, depending on the effect you're going for. For this particular image, I am going to increase the contrast by bringing down the darker areas and make the lighter areas a bit lighter, like so. Next, it's time for the fun part, coloring. So let's add a new gradient map adjustment layer and set up our colors. I am going to use this gradient map preset, and you can download this selection of my presets by following the link in the description box below. Or you can create your own gradients if you want. Just make sure to include at least 4 or 5 color stops, starting with a dark color, then a couple of rich and bright colors, and then some light colors for coloring highlights and whites in your artwork. After you have picked your colors, you can also play around with the distribution of the colors by adjusting the location of the color stops and midpoints. This will allow you to further fine-tune the look to your liking. This looks good, so I am going to apply it to my artwork. Now you might notice some weird graphic stuff and color banding in your artwork that just doesn't look great. So let's fix it. First, let's create another new layer, set it to Overlay with a neutral gray color. I'll call this layer Noise, and then turn it into a Smart Object. Next, let's select this layer and go to the Filter menu and add a Noise filter to it. I usually set the amount to around 10%. Select Gaussian and check the monochromatic box. This gives the artwork a nice grainy look and somewhat conceals some of the color banding. If you want a little more or a little less noise, you can always go back and change the amount. And that's the benefit of applying the noise filter to a smart object. Now, if you want your image to look even smoother, there is one more thing you can do. First, group all your image layers together and rename the group to keep things tidy. Then convert the group into a smart object and duplicate it. Next, select the new smart object layer and head to the filter menu, blur, and select Gaussian blur. Set the radius to about 50 pixels. That's a good starting point for images of 4000 pixels or more, but you can always experiment with different settings to achieve your desired look. I am going to set mine to 50 pixels and apply the changes. Because we have applied the blur effect to a smart object, you can always go back and adjust the blur radius later if necessary. If you're happy with the blurred look, you can stop here. I usually lower the opacity of the blurred layer to get some of the details from the original layers to show through. And then check out different blending modes as well. As I don't want to change the look too much, I will set it to lighten. But you could play around with other blending modes and see what kind of effects you can create. This looks good to me, and we're almost done. Before you export your artwork, make sure the layer order in the Layers panel is correct with the Noise layer at the top and the Gradient Map Adjustment layer just below it. If you feel like adding more graphic elements, like some text or shapes, go ahead and get creative. And once you're happy with everything, save and export your artwork in the desired format and share it with the world. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope you have enjoyed it, picked up a few new Photoshop tricks, and are excited to start creating your own abstract gradient artworks in Adobe Photoshop using this technique. Don't forget to grab the free download of gradient map presets I used in this tutorial to quickly get started with creating exciting, colorful artworks. We'd love to see what you come up with using this technique, so make sure to tag us at Attitude Creative if you post your experiments on Instagram. And let us know in the comment section below what you're planning to create using this technique. Will it be just separate artworks or backgrounds? Or maybe you will incorporate your abstract pieces in your design projects? We would love to hear your thoughts. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more tutorials and content. And if you're looking for a more thorough and structured learning experience, personal guidance, and project feedback, be sure to check out our online courses. Thanks for watching, and I will be looking forward to seeing you in our other videos and courses.